Now let's talk about fixed rates. We've talked about variable rates, yes, whether the rates could go up based on the RBA. Fixed rates, again, you're locking yourself in. Can you explain the fixed rate process as a consumer?
Yeah, absolutely. So a fixed rate is exactly that. You're locking yourself in for a period of time. Now, it can be anywhere between 1 and 5 years, generally speaking. And each term has its own advertised rate. So if you wanted security for the next 3 years, there's an interest rate that's charged for that 3 year period. The great thing about fixed rates is if you lock in an interest rate today for 3 years, and let's call it 2.89%, regardless of what the Reserve Bank of Australia does, if interest rates go up, you're locked in at 2.89%. But if interest rates go down, you're still locked in at 2.89%. So a fixed rate is great only. You don't ever take a fixed rate to try to catch the bottom of the market, because you could be bitterly disappointed. Instead, you take a fixed rate and you choose a term just so you know and understand what your cost or your expenditure is for the next 2 years, 3 years, or 5 years. Yeah. And that's what we tell all of our clients. Take a fixed rate term so you know what your budget and expenditure will be over that period. Don't do it trying to catch the bottom of the market, because you could be disappointed.
And when you've got extra money in those home loan accounts, yes, can you pull the money out when you've got a fixed rate?
Okay, good question. So, and when a loan is fixed, again, this is why you need to talk with your broker or your bank and understand, because quite often if we get bonuses or tax return and you get this extra money, and we do get extra money from time to time that we want to put against the loan, fixed rates predominantly don't allow you, if you do pay extra, to redraw the money back out and take back your own money. Also, if they have an offset account, generally speaking, the offset feature